today's trends, you look at today's kids, if you go ahead and ask them what would they like to polish about themselves, most of their examples will be, you know, I would like to be like that person. I would like to be like that person. That person is completely different to what you are. What they have, you don't have. What you have, they don't have. So polish that uniqueness.
In a world where we're bombarded with fashion choices, I wanted to talk to someone who could decode fashion for both men and women from the perspective of body confidence, positivity, and current social trends. Today's guest is someone who spent the last 15 years in the business of fashion, is an image consultant, and is also the jury member and mentor for India's Next Top Model. Please welcome Mr. Neeraj Gaba. Hi, Neeraj.
Hey, hi, Anshu. How are you doing? Long time.
Long time seeing you, but meeting you, but thanks to the pandemic. But I'm so excited to have you here.
Thank you so much. It was very kind of you. मतलब आपने फोन किया और आपने बोला कि नीरज जी कर सकते हैं तो मैंने कहा क्यों नहीं भैया क्यों नहीं
yeah, जरूर yeah because you know I was we've gotten a lot of guests from different walks of life हमने सबके साथ में we've discussed about things that they represent and they you know stand for and I was thinking कि यार मतलब pandemic में one thing which is very closely associated to all of us is fashion has taken a toss right and I said, who do I talk to for fashion? And I was like, okay, I has to be the oldest friend.
That's very kind of you. That's very, very, very kind of you to think of it.
I'm going to try and keep, you know, fashion from my point of view perspective because I believe that I represent that set of people for whom fashion is important. But it's also, it's a very personal thing, right? And it's not flamboyant fashion. For people like me who are working and, you know, have homes to take care and have kids and there's time constraint. Of course, money constraint, everybody has, right? But tell me, Neeraj, in work from home scenarios and in the last 1.5 years of what we have all seen, where does fashion come in? Ab, matlab, kya ho raha hai fashion? I was like, dude, ironical hai na, ki matlab, aap work from home scenario mein kya fashion matlab, discuss karoge? So, I was like, nahin karte hain.
हाँ बिकॉज अंशु आई बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट अगर आप देखो जैसे इंडस्ट्रीज जो कि निकल के आ रही हैं जिनको बहुत ज्यादा फर्क पड़ा है उनमें से एक हमारा लाइव इवेंट्स है एक आपके जितने भी यू नो सिनेमा मॉल्स होटल्स हॉस्पिटैलिटी ओवरऑल एंड द अदर इंडस्ट्री दैट इज रियली इम्पैक्टेड इज फैशन
फैशन
बिकॉज लोगों ने घर से निकलना बंद कर दिया घर से निकलना बंद कर दिया तो खाली स्वेट शर्ट और स्वेट पैंट के अंदर लोगों ने अपने पूरे पूरे हफ्ते गुजारने शुरू कर दिए और जूम कॉल के ऊपर तो आप खैर एनी विच वेज विदाउट वीडियो भी काम कर सकते हैं बट व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज अ गुड थिंग दैट इज हैपनिंग इज सी बिकॉज वी आर फॉलोइंग अ लॉट ऑफ कंट्रीज दैट हैव ऑलरेडी काइंड ऑफ नाउ ओपनड अप
Yes.
So if I look into the US, if I look into that part of the world, there are special studies that are coming out to how, I mean, फैशन जैसा आपने बोला ना रोजमर्रा के पहनने के लिए मिडिल क्लास के लिए नॉट कुट्योर बट प्रेट देयर स्टडीज आर शोइंग दैट इट इज नॉट इवन लाइक अ वी काइंड ऑफ अ रिकवरी इट इज ऑलमोस्ट लाइक अ टिक रिकवरी इट इज गोइंग सो स्ट्रांग इन दिस सेगमेंट ऑफ फैशन बिकॉज एवरीबडी इज सडनली कमिंग आउट ऑफ देयर होम्स और घर से निकलते समय क्योंकि अब इतने टाइम से कुछ खरीदा ही नहीं है एवरीबडी वॉन्ट्स टू गेट इन टू यू नो वॉट इज टूडे Because they all need to go back to office. So I am thinking that India and the rest of the part of the world will also when they open up. So वहाँ पर भी एक ये same thread चलेगा, जहाँ पर when you have to go back to your workspace, you would like to be seen. You know, because when you are at your work, there's a certain kind of I won't use the word ego, but there's a certain kind of pride that you carry in your carriage.
Absolutely.
So that becomes very important, and there's a persona to your position. And that persona has kind of gone for a toss over this COVID bit.
Yeah.
So I think, yeah, so fashion is going to kind of come back.
So two questions. Pret is everyday fashion?
Pret is everyday fashion. And couture would be, which is like a one-off, which is a one-off piece that is made and which sells in...
Thank you. Thank you for enlightening. But, you know, you said something very nice. Tell me, in when you are at work or jab aap kaam pe jaate ho, whatever you wear becomes a part of who you are, right? And now that who you are has been taken away because aap, and I was thinking the other day because I stepped out after a very long time and I dressed up and simple, yeah. but like new clothes, right? Yeah. And I was like, oh my God, it's making me feel normal. But Neeraj, kuch to hoga, jo even when you're staying at home, even when you're indoors, how does that part, we can, I mean, and this is going to be long from what I understand, right? We are going to stay indoors. We are going to be confined a lot more in the coming years, you know, if this doesn't get over soon. How do you ensure ki aap, matlab, apni confinement mein, and har tarah ki confinement mein, you still continue to carry those little pieces of fashion which make you happy, which make you feel confident, which, which make you you?
Yeah, see, fashion has been evolving over a period of time, even pre-corona. So what had happened was people from those fitted clothes had any which ways kind of started to move into the comfort zone. Jisko hum bolte hain athleisure, anti-fit.
Yeah.
So, you know, those were the kind of things which were free. They were like free hanging things. They do not snug to your body. You can breathe in them. So that setup, I mean, that kind of a trend had already started. Aur jab se hum log ghar pe aaye hain. See, here what happens is the moment you're home and when you're sitting in front of the camera, like when you and I are doing this interview, it's only the upper half that you can see.
Absolutely.
Or everybody.
Yeah.
So everybody has gone into that zone that, okay, you know what? This is my persona.
Yeah.
Niche kya hai? Nobody cares. It's the frame.
Yeah.
What the frame covers.
Yeah.
So, a lot of people like athleisure, jaise maine bola, so, you know, sweat t-shirt, sweat pants, and something which you can breathe in, which ab aap kaam kar rahe ho because it is work from home. You cannot do ki aapne abhi kuch pehna, phir jaise hi call khatam hua, aap gaye, change kiya, phir aapne apna kitchen ka kaam kiya, phir aapka koi call hai, aap wapas aaye, aapne phir kuch aur pehna. So something that will kind of take you through the day. Maximum what people can go through is, okay, you know, chalo, do changes is still possible. And please remember, when you are home and you have to do everything yourself, however many number of helps you have, you still want to contain the kind of things that you're using up.
So
it is kind of getting into that zone of comfort, something that can easily be used over a number of times. Because nobody, like, you know, when we go to offices, ek bahut dimag mein hota hai, maine aaj ye pehna, to is hafte ki meri ye 5 looks hain.
Absolutely.
So then if I have to even repeat something, I will make sure that I kind of mix and match so it doesn't look like it's something that I've worn earlier. However, that trend is changing because we are working from home. We are now looking for something that even if I repeat, the repeatability value of that garment should be good. It should not look like, you know, ghis gaya hai, yeah, after you've done the laundry, because I feel dry cleaners bhi bahut sare khule nahi hue hain. So everything is being washed and done home. So it is the usability also that is becoming a very, so fit and usability and obviously color. Because people, you know, colors kind of brighten you up. And when you're sitting confined to those walls, you want to wear something which will kind of cheer up the mood off the screen as well.
Yeah. I actually look forward to my recordings because those are the days when I actually dress up, put on makeup, wear jewelry. I think for me, jewelry is a huge part of, you know, how I dress
up. For everybody. Accessories, I mean, is the next market. Accessories, kidswear is the next fashion market that's going to add menswear. These are the three markets that are going to take off like anything.
Sure. I mean, so Neeraj, you know, one of the things you've mentored and coached people on India's Next Top Model. You work with a lot of young people from fashion within, I mean, when you are doing your shows, etc., all of that. But besides that, also you've been coaching and mentoring a lot of people, a lot of young kids, right? And there is this, I want to break it down, but there is this entire thing of while we are following a lot of fashion on social media because everything is accessible, but we're all very confused, right? Today, you know, some of the top bloggers will share 50 brands under 5,000, under 10,000, under this and all, and there's no end to it. How do I follow that trend? Like if I'm a 25-year-old, you know, girl, if I am... If I am a 25-year-old girl who has little money to spend, but I don't know how to catch up, how do you catch up to fashion?
First of all, you still look much younger to your real age. I would not go into the numbers.
Thank you, Neeraj.
Most welcome. And the second thing is, I don't know, Anshu, you know, I have always been one of those people who has gone ahead and professed that don't go after trends. गो आफ्टर जो आपको सूट करता है, बिकॉज हम लोग का सबका बॉडी जो होता है वो एक अलग अलग टाइप का होता है, सबका स्किन टोन अलग है, सबका यू नो द एनवायरमेंट इज डिफरेंट, सो एवरीथिंग इज वेरी डिफरेंट. सो येस, इट इज वेरी गुड टू गो अहेड एंड गेट इंस्पायर्ड फ्रॉम व्हाट यू सी, बट प्लीज डू नॉट गो अहेड एंड ट्राई एंड कॉपी, बिकॉज रिमेंबर द पिक्चर्स दैट यू सी ऑन सोशल मीडिया, एटलीस्ट 50 or 60 of them get clicked and only one is uploaded, which is the best out of the lot. And those looks that you go for, they may be just for screen. You know how when we are shooting, there are so many things that are very ill-fitted, but to go ahead because we know, ek yahan taanka lagaya, ek yahan pe safety pin dala, ek yahan kiya, but it kind of gives you that dhansa. And once you're there on camera, it's done. And then, agar aap wohi pura garment dekhoge, you'll be like, oh God, what was this? So a lot of things go behind the camera as well. So my suggestion to everybody who's 25 and or, you know, the age that...
Any age, actually.
Yeah. Any age, actually. They should look for comfort. They should look for something which is representing their personality. Because at the end of the day, aap jo pehante ho, you are actually, you know, you wear your confidence on the inside and in your eyes. But clothes are something that add on to your expressing that confidence. So the moment you start wearing something which you are not comfortable in, which is not you, you start looking inconfident. And I don't think today anybody wants to do that to themselves.
How? Tell me something. Sorry, I'm cutting you in. When you say you start looking inconfident or whatever that word is, right? Aap, because aap models ke saath kaam karte ho, aap unko batate ho ki how to look confident. What are those signs wherein you figure out ki ye confident nahi hai banda ya bandi?
आपको खुद पता चल जाएगा. यू नो, यू विल बी एबल टू सी दैट समबडी हु इज लाइक, बिकॉज यू आर रेफरिंग टू मॉडल्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, मॉडल्स बिकॉज ऑफ देयर प्रोफेशन, इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम टू से दैट आई एम नॉट
कॉन्फिडेंट. या
और नॉट कॉन्फिडेंट बिकॉज दैट इज देयर प्रोफेशन. सो इट विल बी वेरी अनजस्ट टू गोइंग काइंड ऑफ गोइंग अहेड एंड यू नो कंपेयरिंग व्हाट अ मॉडल गोस थ्रू टू व्हाट अ रेगुलर पर्सन गोस थ्रू. हैविंग बट देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ अदर मॉडल्स. सो इफ आई गिव एन एग्जांपल ऑफ यू नो व्हाट वी कॉल अ प्लस साइज मॉडल्स. Yes. Or full-bodied models, okay?
Yes.
Now, if I go ahead, because they're on the ramp, they will wear anything that you'll give them because at the end of the day, it is work. But yeah. If I tell them to go ahead and wear something, now imagine I give you something which is really tight on the top. And, you know, from, it just looks then, I'm sorry to use the word, it looks obscene. And sure. You can make out that you're not comfortable. There are a lot of women who are either very tall, or, you know, very short ones. So very short ones, if you give them this one long garment, which makes them look further shorter, you can see that, you know, they're just trying to carry it with putting a heel in it or doing something so they can carry that garment off. It doesn't work on them. If they go ahead and start wearing something, which is a combination of a garment and a little bit of skin showing, it'll actually make them look taller. So my suggestion to everybody is that, you know, go ahead and find what suits you. Take inspiration, and when you're inconfident, no, आपको आंखों में, आपको चाल में, आपको बैठने उठने में, आपको सब तरफ से दिखेगा. क्यों? हम लोग कहीं भी जाते हैं, you know, हम लोग जैसे कहीं शादियों में जाते हैं. I'll give you one very live example. So I know a lady in the family, okay, a middle class Punjabi housewife who through her life has worn saris and suits, like Punjabi suits. Now, her son was getting married, and because these days there are all these functions that happen, so like a year or back, before the COVID happened, so her son was getting married, and then they had a cocktail night. Now, she comes to me and says, you know what, I'm thinking of wearing a cocktail gown. Now, for me, thank God she could not see me over the phone, my eyes went, what? Because I have seen her in that way, and I know what her comfort level is.
Sure.
For her to wear a cocktail gown, I was like, you know what, you're going to make a joke out of yourself. And then I had to very politely explain to her what is a cocktail gown and how, what you should be in your kind of a physical being to be able to, because otherwise you don't want to become a butt of jokes, right? Just because you're trying to copy a trend. And the statement that she started off with was, oh, you know what, maine bahut sari shaadiyon mein dekha hai, cocktail rounds ke andar na, mothers bhi aajkal cocktail gowns pehen rahi hain. I mean, I don't know. So I just felt bad for her that she was falling for something which she shouldn't. So, yeah.
But tell me something, you know, I have a other way of looking at it, and, you know, as a woman, and because we're suddenly now exposed to new this thing, pehle to sirf salwar kameez ya saadi hoti thi, right? And I've seen this with, you know, women of a lot of women of my mother's age, that now because they have that option of wearing a cocktail gown or even dresses for that matter, right, they also want to try.
Yeah,
I mean, whether it's their body or not, they have that body or not, they also want to. And I mean, what's the harm in doing that?
No, there is no harm. There is no harm. But if you ask me for an opinion, I would be lying if I don't go ahead and give you the correct opinion, right? I was coming from that space. Even forget about a lady. Even if a gentleman comes today with that big paunch and tells me that, you know what, I'm trying to go ahead and get into this like tight fitted suit. My suggestion to them would be, please don't do that to yourself. Because you will actually look like a ball just rolled down and the ball is just going. So there are multiple things that one needs to take into consideration. Now, there are a lot of, like I told you about short girls. Now, a lot of very tall girls, because somewhere in our society, it is said that, oh, you know what, ladki itni lambi nahi honi chahiye. So I'm combining all the effects here. Because itna unke dimaag mein dal diya jata hai that they start slouching. Because somewhere they think when they slouch,
I've seen
they look shorter.
I've seen that happen to a lot of like taller girls.
Exactly. So there is a lot of mental conditioning. So where I'm coming from is mental conditioning of self and mental conditioning of everybody around you. So experimenting, fashion is all about experimenting. If nobody would have experimented, fashion wouldn't have evolved at all. You would have still been stuck in those things. However, there is something like I call, in a very managementy way, something which is called a calculated risk. So one needs to kind of be a little bit aware and उतनी ही बात है. ट्राई करने में कोई हक नहीं है. दुनिया में किसी को आपका मजाक उड़ाने का हक भी नहीं है. मैं तो वहां से आता हूँ. बट एट द सेम टाइम यू नीड टू बी अवेयर दैट एवरीबडी इज नॉट एज अवेयर एज यू आर.
सो यू नो, इन इंडिया, एंड दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई हैव आल्सो बीन गिल्टी प्रोबेबली ऑफ यूजिंग वंस और ट्वाइस, बट एंड कमेंटेड ऑन अदर पीपल सेइंग, यार ये अपनी उम्र के हिसाब से ड्रेस नहीं करते हैं. Dressing
we
according to
that.
Urge,
we
right? And it's somewhere to do with the mental conditioning that we've all grown up with. Mummy hogi to sari ya salwar kameez pehnegi, ya, you know, this thing. At least, you know, when you move, once you move out of Bombay and Delhi and bigger metros, you will find mothers only in salwar kameez or this thing. What does this dressing according to age mean? Actual meaning kya hai? Kuch concept hai dressing to according to age? Ya aapko lagta hai ki aisa kuch hona hi nahi chahiye?
What does
fashion say?
Fashion says there is no boundary at all. Today, the biggest discrimination that since the day we know human beings that has been coming is male and female.
Yeah.
Today, fashion is going gender neutral.
Yeah.
I think that's the biggest example it can be said. So what is age? If there is gender neutrality happening, then what is age? Age, any which way, is a number. We all have been saying it for years. It's just that we don't put it into practice. So when the example that I gave you was also, it was nothing to do with her age. It was to do with her confidence and the mental conditioning of the crowds that she'll be in. And because she's somebody close to me and she's come to me for an opinion, it was my responsibility that I give her the honest response. So it was nothing to deter her, but it was just to go ahead and create that awareness in her that you've never done this before. So if you're doing it, please be ready for it.
Okay.
That's
interesting.
The only.
Interesting. So, you know, we obviously have a list of
and
questions.
Fashion is, sorry. And fashion is all about, you know, what you feel and what you believe in. It is like your action. It is your individual responsibility. Tomorrow you want to go ahead and wear that, you know, there's this denim that has come out. A very high fashion brand has brought it out. It's a denim which is completely tattered. It only covers your bare essentials. That's the trend. Can
that's
everybody
trend.
Carry it off? I don't think so.
Oh,
would you like to wear it?
The number
I'm asking you openly.
I would love to. I love tattered jeans. So.
No. I'm saying tattered, which covers only your bare.
Oh, okay. No, maybe not. I don't think so. I have the confidence also to carry it, and I don't think so. I wouldn't want to be in that place if I.
I was only referring to this reflection. Nothing more.
Yeah. Interesting. But, you know, there are a lot of young girls who have the body type, But because of the conditioning that we've all been brought up with, right? And they have beautiful, beautiful bodies and amazingly, you know, beautiful girls, pretty girls, smart girls,
everybody,
I would say.
Everybody's beautiful.
Yeah.
Everybody is beautiful.
A lot of them.
We need to acknowledge it to ourselves that I'm beautiful.
Yes.
And not given to the world.
Agreed. 100%. A lot of them, you know, when I talk to people, because I've literally grown up in various cities across India, right? So I still have those roots there. A lot of them will say, ki yaar, confidence nahi hai carry karne ka. How does one build confidence if you have the body type to wear certain type of clothes? How do you build that confidence to wear
it's
a
like
certain type of clothes?
It's like how you build life, Anshu. When you stepped into your career the first day, were you this confident as you are today?
No, we failed and we failed together, Neeraj. Don't remind me.
But that's what I'm saying. But that's exactly what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So it is just because, you know, it's like something, how should I say? There are a few things that we give this extra importance to in our society.
Yeah.
For example, if I say sex.
Huh.
Sex is given an overly undue importance.
Huh.
What is sex? It's a bodily need. It's an expression between two people or X number of people.
Yeah.
And the responsibility lies between whosoever is doing it. Anybody out of it should not even have anything to say about it. It's
absolutely
just that people want to go ahead and express, and that's why the hoopla is there. And that's why there is so much of ignorance when it comes to sex. And that's why sex education is so vital here, when it should be something which should be taught in schools like everywhere else in the world it is. In our country, it is not. Similar goes with fashion. Fashion is an expression of how you're feeling that day.
Yes.
It should not be this big a hoopla. We have made it.
Hmm.
It's something that, okay, you know what? Today, if I feel like walking out in shorts, I'm in the mood for shorts, dude. If I don't want to go ahead and wear a full-length skirt, which my legs can't be seen and blah, 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 blah. And then a lot of other factors, I'm sure, also come in. I mean, with again, all due respect, the security reasons.
Yeah.
And today, the security goes for either of the sexes. It's not just one.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, I think there is more awareness at a base level that is required for people's, I won't say intelligence quotient, their emotional evolution quotients also need to kind of be evolved. And that can only happen if this kind of knowledge, this kind of expressions are allowed from schooling days, wherein people are taught, wherein in our education system, it is made more democratic, and wherein it's not just organized schools. It is the unorganized sector also that is provided with a certain manner of wherein, you know, they bring in somebody who comes, who speaks, who talks, and brings that awareness. Dimag ki khidkiyan nahi khulenge, to wo to bachche hai na yaar.
Condition
ho jayenge. Unko to jo dikhta hai, wo condition mein aise hi ho jayenge. Hum puri zindagi condition ho jate hain.
Yeah.
Hum log ki zindagi mein, we all are born, when we are a child, we are born with no conditioning whatsoever. But as we evolve, as we grow, matlab from mother's milk to walking, to saying that first word, to going to school, any which ways we are so conditioned by then only, forget about the remaining line. It's all to do with conditioning.
You know, it reminds me of something which I have observed a lot in the last 15 years I've been part of entertainment. And I mean, you know, I've always observed that Indian actors, female actors or Indian models, they're very still very, very, though they are all models and they're very confident and we have some amazing talent. The moment you bring Firangi models, Firangi faces, there is a certain type of confidence that they bring in, which you can't compare to Indian when you're on show. I mean, and you know what I'm talking about, right? Why is that difference?
Conditioning. Yeah. You have the answer.
Yeah.
They are brought up in, I mean, most of them, we go ahead. Not all. Because when we say for us, Firangi, actually the definition of Firangi is a British. Because Firangi started and colonized. So an American is not a Firangi. A South American
I would say foreigners, foreign models. Foreign actors.
Yeah. So foreign.
Foreign
models,
dancers.
Anybody for that matter, you need to see the amount of evolution they have, that they have left their country. And they've come to a new place, which is a so-called third world country, for them to experience their career growth. So imagine the amount of confidence they have because of the kind of conditioning they have been brought up in. Even if they were not brought up in that kind of conditioning, they have evolved to that space.
Yeah.
So when they come to this space, obviously they have left their whole world and they've come here. If they don't portray confidence, then who will? So the here, aap par wo bolte na, matlab, aisa bhi nahi hai ki ghar ki murgi dal barabar, because we have such great talent in our country.
Yeah,
however, if we go ahead and we kind of, so we can't generalize this. However, yes, what you're saying, but unke liye it is a situation of,
karo ya maro.
Karo ya maro type sort of situation.
Huh.
Because they're on a work visa here, if they don't get work, and in this industry, it's all about confidence. And if you don't go ahead and portray that, then thank you, you'll be back. So for them, that's more like a need than a want.
So you mean to say, I mean, see, we can't control what environment we are conditioned in for people like you and me, because we've been big, we've been hamari schooling ho chuki hai. But I think,
and thankfully, we have been brought up in very open conditions. We have
continue to evolve.
Yeah.
Exactly. We continue to realize that, you know, this thing. And then we are doing self-affirmation, saying, okay, I'm amazing. Or, you know, I have the body confidence to kind of carry this and all. So I think one of the answers that I feel you're trying to tell me is mental conditioning, even for the current lot, wherein you say, I can do this, I can carry this, I can wear this, and I'm confident.
It depends. Again, see, mental conditioning is a given for everybody. Mm. Whether you come from whichever strata of society, that does not matter.
Mm.
Till the time you are not conditioned to do something, you will always be fearful of doing it.
Yeah.
But I think the kind of sect that you are trying to get this information through is people who do not come from a very open background, which is like tier 2, tier 3 city.
Even tier 1 actually.
Petros
में भी बहुत है, बॉम्बे में भी बहुत मिलेंगे.
मैं खाली generalize करने के लिए मैं जा रहा था वहाँ पे, but otherwise.
Yeah.
So वहाँ पे तो फिर that you know it is a very personal thing that how much are you able to go ahead and find that balance between your evolution until where your family would allow. क्योंकि कई बार क्या होता है ना, अंशु जैसे आपने मुझे बोला ना, मैं बहुत सारे ये यूथ के साथ अलग अलग जगह से मेरी बातचीत होती रहती है. सो दे ऑलवेज टेल मी दिस वन थिंग, नहीं सर आपको नहीं पता है, नहीं अलाउ कर रहे हैं, ये नहीं है, वो नहीं है. सो माय ओनली क्वेश्चन टू देम इज, आर यू टेलिंग मी दैट समथिंग और देयर वाज समथिंग दैट यू रियली वांटेड टू डू इन योर लाइफ एंड यू हैव नेवर डन दैट? एंड दैट आंसर इज ऑलवेज, नहीं सर वो तो. आई सेड एग्जैक्टली. So when you know, as they say, where there's a will, there's a way. When you know how to go ahead, because every kid knows how to manipulate their parents. Every kid. So if you want a way out of it, because sabne kiya hai na,
you have to explain to them. You have to, go one step at a time. Yeah.
Exactly. So you need to go ahead and kind of bring that awareness into them that when you are saying that you can't do this, more than somebody stopping you on the outside, you are your first hindrance. First, you need to be mentally convinced that this is what I want to do.
Yeah.
हमारी generation, ये जो अभी generation आ रही है ना, इनके अंदर क्या हो रहा है कि एक होता है inspire होना और एक होता है खुद का दिमाग छोड़कर ये बोलना कि oh you know what, that is exactly what I want to do. But that doesn't work. You getting inspired in a manner that, oh, you know what, this kind of seems aligned and now I need to find my path and my way. मुझे अब खुद का रास्ता ढूंढना है कि रास्ता मुझे ठीक लग रहा है, अब मैं अपने लिए उसको कैसे रास्ता बनाऊं. Very few find that reflection in themselves. So they kind of start, like their attention spans are reducing, they have started jumping paces as well. They are not going as gradual a progression as it should be.
It's interesting because even fashion as a term or whatever you want to call it, it's a process which kind of helps you explore yourself and find yourself.
You express yourself from within. आप कभी भी वो नहीं पहनोगे जो कि आपका मन नहीं है पहनने का. Especially when you know that, okay, you know, when you're stepping out, घर पे तो चलो nobody cares. Sorry, you were saying something. I interrupted.
No, you didn't. Tell me, how often, you know, if I am a normal middle class person, right? But I really love dressing up. I love jewelry. And of course, there's abundance of it the moment you open Instagram, right? And I might want to, I just get confused, right? In terms of buying. Now, it's a very personal question. But what's your take? How do I ensure ki main, I stay latest, you know, I stay updated in terms of trend wherein I own some stuff. At the same time, you know, I don't want to spend too much. What's your take on how do you kind of balance that? How do you deal with that situation?
It's a situation of demand and supply.
Yes.
Demand coming from you and supply coming from that Instagram channel.
There's enough supply, more than the demand.
I know. That's exactly where I'm coming from. Because your demand comes with a certain background, which is the amount of resources that you have, the requirement that you have. What is the kind of requirement that you have, whether it is for a function, whether it is for something ghar pe. So there are many, many backgrounds to that demand. Supply side knows, because of the kind of channels that they are on, they can go ahead and create
data.
That full strategy. They can go ahead and do that full strategy.
Yeah.
They don't even have to push anything.
Yeah.
So the moment I put it out, I know the moment it is in front of your eyes, even if you have to go and step out of your resources, step away from them, that is how credit card industry functions. So you will do that. So what one needs to do is, I think you need to find that balance basis. What do you require and what are the kind of resources you have? We all need to understand this, that anything that you buy today, and if you continue keep buying multiples of it, you're not being a responsible citizen of this planet. So one needs to, that, you know, the words that are coming out like reuse, recycle, and all these things are very, very, very important to stay with trends. Very independent choice. But at the same time, to go ahead and zabardasti ka kharidna, that is one thing that you need to keep a check on. Because there is a lot of, I wouldn't call it exposure. There is a lot of exposure. Pehle nahi hota tha. Pehle aapko ek dukaan pe jana padta tha. Aap kabhi kabhi jaate the. Today the dukaan is in your hand.
Yeah.
So you need to kind of keep that check on yourself. And you want to buy, but ration yourself. Very important, like, you know, how corona needs to be dealt with, which is about self-regulation. Same goes for any kind of shopping. It is completely to do with self-regulation. You want to buy, nobody is stopping you from buying, but be a regulated buyer. Don't go ahead and just keep buying and buying and buying and buying, because there is no end to it. By the end of it, you will only end up being frustrated because of X, Y, Z reasons, which were not matching to your budget. So, yeah.
One of my strategies is the cart strategy, wherein you put everything in the cart, but you don't buy it immediately.
Don't buy it. Were you looking for that kind of an answer? Yeah, that's
yes.
A very good one. That's a very, very, very good one.
It's literally called the cart strategy.
Yes, yes. Sab kuch jaake wo cart mein dalte jao, but when it comes to checkout,
I look at it after like 2 days again, and then, especially with books.
Yeah, yeah. No, so, but you know, Anshu, you are an evolved buyer. Here, if we are addressing the young ones are very instinctive buyers.
Yeah, that's true.
So there, for them, like I was talking about mental conditioning, this is another aspect of mental conditioning, that they should stop having that reaction to everything and hear the reaction being buying. They need to become more responsive. Jaisa aapne bola card strategy, rakho usko. Do teen din ka gap jaane do, wo wahan pe available tab bhi hoga.
Yeah.
Go back again. If you still feel everything is matching with the back end and still the desire is there to buy that, then think about it again.
Agreed.
Don't be very reactive to it.
Agreed. I think we're going to move almost to the end of the conversation, Neeraj. This is going to be a slightly personal question from your journey perspective, right? In my mind, having worked in entertainment for the last so many years, I feel fashion is one of the most difficult industries to work with, right? It's a challenging industry purely because of hours, because of a lot of other things that, you know, fashion. It's also a short-lived period. But you've been in fashion for a very, very long time. What are those 2 or 3, 4 things that helped you sustain yourself in an industry like fashion? Of course, you've evolved. You've done a lot of different things, right? But what are those 3 or 4 things, solid things that kind of helped you sustain and, you know, try and do newer things and, you know, aim for larger things?
So, you know, for this, there's an acronym that I formed. I was speaking at one of the fashion institutes. Mm-hmm. And suddenly, I mean, these kids were, they were having all these questions. And I don't know from where this acronym came into my head. And kind of, it has kind of become a Bible, because when I now sit and think about my journey, that acronym is basically the crux of it. And that acronym goes as SUD. S-U-D. S stands for Shiddat. Aap jo bhi karo na, jo bhi karo, apni jaan dal ke karo. पूरे आई मीन बिल्कुल 1000% अपना देखे करो. आई एम अ लिविंग एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस दैट इफ यू डू योर जॉब बेटर देन आई मीन बेटर देन व्हाट यू एक्सपेक्टेड, फॉरगेट व्हाट एनीबडी एल्स एक्सपेक्टिंग, इवन इफ यू सरपास योर एक्सपेक्टेशंस आउट ऑफ योरसेल्फ, दैट इज व्हेन यू आर डूइंग योर जॉब वेल. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई नेवर से 100%, आई ऑलवेज से 1000%. शिद्दत. सेकेंड थिंग इज यूनिकनेस. यू स्टैंड फॉर यूनिकनेस. आज की दुनिया में इन दिस टाइम ऑफ सो कॉल्ड इंस्पिरेशन, फनी इट इज, वी ऑल लुक फॉर यूनिकनेस, वेदर इट इज अ पार्टनर, वेदर इट इज सम फैशन ट्रेंड वी वांट टू बाय, वेदर इट इज एन एक्सेसरी, वेदर इट इज एनीथिंग इन आवर लाइफ, वी वुड लाइक टू हैव समथिंग दैट इज ओनली विद अस फॉर अस. कॉपी नहीं होना चाहिए कहीं तो और किसी और के पास, नहीं तो उसका वेटेज कम हो जाएगा, राइट? बट वी आर सो far away from going ahead and polishing our uniqueness, because we always get inspired. Not only just inspired. So I was working with this one of the salon chains in the country, and one of their team members went ahead and said, Neeraj, you will not believe, we have these brides who come to us with images of Bollywood celebrities, and they tell us that, you know what, make me this. I want to look like this tonight. And they're like, we just don't know. I mean, if you see the person who's sitting on the chair and if you see the image, it's completely two different things. That is the amount of ignorance we have. You look at today's trends, you look at today's kids. If you go ahead and ask them what would they like to polish about themselves, most of their examples will be, you know, I would like to be like that person. I would like to be like that person. That person is completely different to what you are. What they have, you don't have. What you have, they don't have. So polish that uniqueness. Like you kind of pointed out that fashion industry is a little difficult industry to be a part of. I wouldn't call it the most difficult. Every industry has its things.
It is definitely one of the most.
It is difficult. It is a difficult industry because of a lot of other reasons as well. However, because I continued sticking to what I knew.
And enjoyed.
I did not go ahead and enjoy it, obviously. And I did not go ahead and start copying, you know, ek wo magic mantra hota hai na, bhai agar ye yahan se wahan pahunch gaye hain to let me start copying, maybe my journey will become easier. Never. Tried to carve my own path, and I think that is the reason that uniqueness kind of is paying off, because of whatever reasons it is. That if there is something that I can do, maybe only I can do.
Sure.
That kind of stuff.
Sure.
Then comes to the next part of it, which is called D. D ka matlab hai Hindi mein dhakke khana. Hum sab ne Anshu dhakke khaye hain. Koi aake bol de jisne dhakke nahi khaye, to main maan jaun. Unless you are born with that silver spoon, where directly from your business school you get to sit in the
challenges
hote
hain. Unke apne bhi apne challenges
hote hain. Sabke apne apne challenges. Because the expectations are very different.
किसी का 1 लाख का चैलेंज होता है, किसी का 10 करोड़ का होता है.
10 करोड़ का चैलेंज, क्या बात है, सही. So this is that debate of nepotism, you know. How you want to cut it, you can cut it.
No, it's okay.
No, because I completely believe in it. I say that whosoever is saying about this nepotism thing, if I am a doctor, I would like to bring, if I've raised my child, if I've raised my son or daughter to be a doctor, and if I have a clinic, I will bring my child to sit in that clinic, man.
No, ultimately, audience decides. Audience decides.
So I completely am completely not into that nepotism wala call. But coming back again to this dhakke khana thing. So please go ahead, because you do not realize how much this dhakke khana makes you learn. You evolve.
Yeah.
You find answers to which you never know when you will need them in your career or in your personal life. So for me, if you ask me how I have been able to sustain, because whatever I have done, I have kind of done from scratch, like ground level up. So if today there are people who are working on the ground level, and if they turn around and tell me, no, this is not possible, I know when they're saying the truth and when they're bullshitting. मैंने उतने धक्के खाए हैं. So yeah, so if should was the answer, then should is the answer.
Interesting. Oh, that was quite an interesting conversation, because most of the guests that I have come, I've kept it very personal. But with you, I felt more than the personal story, there's so much of experience you bring in for the confidence that you bring in out for people, you know, when you're training them, coaching them. I thought, let me grab that opportunity and ask you to speak about all of that.
So I hope you got, you know, some value adding stuff there.
It was definitely a fun conversation, but more than fun, I think it was a lot more personal from a fashion perspective. I follow fashion. I enjoy fashion. It makes me alive, feel alive, and it makes me who I am. And I thought that, you know, in times like these, when fashion is really reduced a lot in the confinement of our homes, I thought, let me bring out and explain to people what fashion and confidence does to you in a situation like this. And, you know, you've pretty much pointed out to all those things. So I'm glad we could speak about all of that. And thank you so much, Neeraj.
Thank you so much for having me. Just a parting thought would be that because we are talking about fashion and we are talking of expression of our personality through fashion, I think everybody must remember that do not do something which in your essence you do not agree with, because it will not agree with your carriage as well. Your carriage is only how you feel inside. Outside is only 5%. 95% of your carriage comes from within. So what you put on your body, what you wear, forget about the clothes, even an audit toilet or a perfume or anything, any kind of makeup, any kind of accessory, anything that you think helps you enhance your physical carriage, only do if you think you are aligned to it. If you think it is not working for you, please, in that very instant, do not wear it, because you will be very conscious. And the moment you are conscious, however beautiful, however expensive that piece of accessory or garment be, you will make it look like worth nothing.
Interesting. If you've enjoyed this conversation, please make sure you hit the like button, comment what was your favorite part, and also subscribe to the channel. We have lots of fantastic people coming up. This podcast is available on your podcast app by the name Questions I Wanted to Ask. You can also follow me on social media for more updates, short format content. Links will be in the description.